Welcome.
Wow.
Go there.
So how's it?
Can I get an offer?
No, no, sir. It's already closed.
Guys, it's a new look. This is a story about Saudi people, not Saudi politics. So this is Mohsin. Mohsin lived in the U.S. for what, 12 years?
About 12 years, yeah.
And you're back in Saudi. You've been here 2 weeks.
Yeah, actually 2 months.
Two months in total. So today with Mohsin, he's going to take us to some cool places, some very interesting places. He said tonight there's even like a big music event or something going on.
Yeah, at the Bolivar.
We're going to have some coffee at Starbucks.
You like Starbucks?
The diplomat corner, yeah.
So this is a diplomatic zone, you're saying?
Yeah.
Is that why there are a lot of trees and security? This is where all the embassies are, basically.
Most of them, yeah.
It's a super hard place to understand. It's a very complex place.
Yeah.
And there are many layers. Saudi's always been looked at as like the most conservative country, I would say, from the outside, right?
Yeah.
And so when I come here and I see women without headscarves, some of them, or, you know, couples out and open hanging out when they're not married, it's definitely like it smashes a lot of preconceptions, I would say.
Yeah,
like, it's very confusing. Okay. It's super confusing and hard to understand. I was at a Starbucks yesterday and there were like, the genders were separated.
Mixing genders more and more.
Yeah.
As you can see around.
You live in Panama.
Correct.
You grew up in Saudi.
Yes.
And you're Lebanese.
Correct.
What did you call that?
Third culture kid.
Wow. So how's it feel to be back in Saudi?
Feels good.
Different?
It is different. It is changing.
You like coming here?
Yes. Wow. I mean, it reminds me of my job. So.
Yeah, cool. Good, yeah. Right on. What's your name? I'm sorry.
Reem,
Peter.
Yes.
Yeah, you're great, Reem.
Starbucks just closed for a prayer time.
Do we do prayer in the Starbucks or no?
No, we don't. They close.
Sure.
It's like a break for their employees. This is a tradition here in Saudi Arabia.
Sorry, sir. No, sir. It's already closed, sir. Sorry.
Thank you, sir.
This is a good place, huh?
Yeah. This is our first stop for today. We are going to go other cool areas.
You're gonna get me a, what is this called, a thobe?
We're gonna get you a thobe.
How is it possible that things change so quickly? So for example, those women we were just talking to, which I didn't get on camera, because it is a bit of a challenge actually to get people on camera, but they were saying that a year ago they had to be fully covered, and now they're walking around without any cover. Like, how does it change so quickly and there are no big problems in it? It seems like there'd be big problems in like such a rapid change, I would think.
I also think that the society is ready for such changes. So it used to be there are certain authorities within Saudi Arabia that are not allowing for that change to happen.
Right.
And these authorities are gone now. The religious police is not allowed in most places in Saudi Arabia right now. Not just this area.
Huh. But a year or two ago, they were allowed, they were everywhere?
Before, 2 years ago, they were everywhere. They had the power to ask women to cover up. Now, this is all gone. You can wear whatever you like. This is the new, this is the new Saudi Arabia, really, literally. 50% of the population under the age of 25, 65% of the population under the age of 30.
Wow.
So you have a huge amount of youth in this country.
Right.
And this is a good news to any country as long as they know how to utilize it and generate a great society and a great economy out of this really young power. It can have bad consequences if this energy is not channeled right. The change in Saudi Arabia will be faced with the resistance from part of the population. That's absolutely true. But I would assume, and I would say from what I witnessed, that the majority of Saudis are in favor of these changes.
Well said, Mo.
Thank you very much.
I think it's interesting. I think it's going to be interesting for you, for sure, coming back 10 years out of it and then into it. And it's definitely interesting for me because I don't know what... What scene from the outside about Saudi, honestly, is beheadings, is lashes, is...
Is
the political narrative, are the political narratives, but there's very little online about like what life is like on the ground. And this is one story. I'm showing one aspect and my perspective of, as a traveler, and I understand that's not by any stretch any full story. The problem is though, I can't talk to very conservative Saudi. You know what I mean? I can't talk to the woman who's very conservative. That's just not gonna work, right? So I do, like, by default, only show the younger, more progressive women are gonna be the ones that are gonna talk to me, or definitely talk in front of a camera.
Well, your trip is still young. You don't know who you are gonna meet.
Welcome.
Thank you, brother.
Nice to meet you.
Can see.
I want like a white. Like a white and a silk one, like
that. Yours is sort of like silky.
Okay, let's try something else.
It's like the kicking ass version.
It's my first thobe.
Thobe underwear. The
Can I get it on, bro?
We're trying to teach him how to wear thobe. Nice.
But it's very stately.
Yeah, nice.
I like
you
it.
Like it?
It's fine. We look the same. We have the same one, yeah?
Guys, it's a new look, and I'm going to rock this throughout Saudi.
Well, actually, this is a very comfortable
style.
Very liberating underneath.
Did I get a pig head?
Is it tied? Oh, it's tied, man. Dude, he said your head is one of the biggest heads they ever had.
Thank you. I have one of the biggest heads in Saudi Arabia. Is that what
you're saying? Yeah.
Yeah, it should be the line now.
No, when you wear it every day, it will stretch.
Bro. Bro, it's a good look, yeah?
Yeah, I'm in it.
Doesn't have a big enough size.
It's Mumtaz.
Mumtaz? I like it like this. Seriously.
How much you can buy?
So the process of buying a thobe doesn't just stop at the store. You actually you get it ironed somewhere else.
This is advanced, dude. You cannot see this anywhere in the world.
Hi. Yeah. I like Belmanda. Why is...
Palestinian? He's calling me a Palestinian?
He's asking what's your nationality.
Palestinian.
America.
San Francisco.
Bengali Vienna Zeda?
Bengali, yeah.
Yeah.
Beeman, Air Beeman, Dhaka.
Bengali Kulu Mangantiara.
How do I see Egypt?
Muscle.
Muscle.
Egypt.
Yeah,
Assalamualaikum. I'm Saudi. So, why Saudi,
eh? Saudi?
Yes. Saudi.
Yeah. Why? Are you Saudi?
I'm Pakistani.
Pakistani?
Yes.
Egyptian? Bengali?
Yes.
Indian? Syrian?
Saudi? Syrian?
Many countries together to his room here. Sir, so, many countries live here.
Super diverse here. Like every nationality in the region is working here in Saudi.
Salam. Salam.
People we met are from diverse backgrounds, right? One of them was amazed. He was like, it's the first time I actually see an American.
Yeah.
Right? The guy from Syria.
The Middle East is usually put over under one label.
Yeah.
And it's usually thought to be this anti-American, anti-Western hotbed.
yes, there are those elements, like they exist for sure. But the vast majority, through all my experiences in the Middle East, people are like that.
Yeah.
You know, they're cool. Yeah. They're like, you're from the States? Cool. It's like a novelty because not too many Yanks are walking down the street there.
Yeah.
That's not usually the choice of vacation they make. So
yeah.
I think there's probably a novelty to it, but it's also like, it's not this anti-American sentiment that you see only on the news, right?
What were you saying? That's instead of 911, that's 999 is emergency?
Yeah.
So the cop cars are the same as US cop cars.
Yeah.
Mojin, please tell us what's going on here. This is a co-working space,
so
right?
This is a co-working space, as you might see.
This is an environment young Saudis come to create their startup.
Yes.
Or...
Yeah.
Cool.
And this is just part of the space.
So do you nap more or you work more, Mojin?
I snap.
Yeah.
It's my first time on camera.
Don't worry about it. It's like it doesn't exist.
All right.
This is a ghost. His name's Mojin. He comes in my nightmares sometimes.
I can give you a prescription for that.
Do it. Yeah. I need some antidote for
anti-night.
Where do you want to go? What city?
Mayo Clinic, hopefully.
Mayo Clinic.
Yeah.
Where is that?
Arizona.
Baltimore?
Arizona.
It's Arizona?
Yes. Yeah. There's two spots. Minnesota
okay.
And Arizona. A lot of people have been studying abroad since a long time ago, actually.
Uh-huh.
But now more people are focusing on going to the US and UK.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Interesting.
How cool. Do you like it real so far?
Dude, it's cool.
It's
yeah.
Cool. Do you like
why
it?
Why do I look more local than you do? I'm just trying to keep this in my head.
No, it's staying well.
But what I'm saying is, like, I'm fresh off the boat.
Yeah.
You have this expression.
Fresh off the boat, yeah.
Just got here. And I can see, well, first of all, it's impossible to understand what this place is like by going online. You have no idea.
Sure.
That's true for everywhere, but more so for here because there's no content.
Yes.
Very little content,
very little content
on the country in like these stories. There were two very cool women in there that spoke perfect English, that were very driven and interesting. They couldn't be on camera. So, sort of the story here, a lot of women for cultural reasons or reasons of not wanting to be seen on camera, just can't be on camera.
This woman and her friend, they're agreeing to drive tomorrow morning. She's gonna do that video on driving with a Saudi woman.
Mm-hmm.
Not happening.
Why?
So, you tell me, man. Everyone seems into the idea, but then when they sit on it a little bit, they decide not to. But then they think about it and they're like, I don't wanna be online driving. I think there's something in that.
Yeah. It just, like, you know, the concept of, you know, being on a video online is just new to a lot of them.
It's new.
Many of them.
Yeah.
It's new to me. This country is hungry for entertainers.
Yeah.
Lots of it. Yeah. Look at this crowded streets.
Of course, there is like entertainment before, but not like at this large scale.
Right, there were no horror shows like we're seeing up here.
I have never seen something like this before. It's a really new experience for the whole public here. That, you know, there's more fun things to do.
Like a fish tank of a coffee shop. Is that a coffee shop?
Yeah.
Wow. Very posh. Bro, I gotta say it's a good, positive
nice vibe
down
yeah,
here.
I'm,
like super upbeat
like
vibe.
It. Yeah,
a lot
yeah.
of smiles, a lot of friendly people like these guys.
Yeah.
And it's actually a good way for people to mix, you know.
People to mix?
Yeah.
What do you mean?
You know, whatever you see here. Look at this. There's no border.
It looks good?
Yeah, man. It looks like Saudi stuff.
Okay, so how's it feel to be back?
Right now, it's fine, man.
It's fine?
Yeah.
It's cool?
What's your name?
Peter.
Shari.
So guys, hope you like that. Day with Mojin. And hope you got something out of that like I did. There was a lot of stimulation, a lot of
nice
mind,
yeah, you should all come here.
And that was quite an epic journey.
Bye. Peace.